That's right. From Eastern Michigan University, this is Unprepared and Confident!
Hey, how's it going tonight? Yeah. So we are Unprepared and Confident. I'm going to hand things over to Samuel to host our first game.
All right, for our first game, we're going to be playing Sam and Alex. Emmett here. He will be in two scenes at the same time, well, not the same time, but in one game. I need, let's see, for Sam, would he Sam, can I get...
I'm Sam.
What?
My name is Sam, her name is Alex. Just
going wow. Woo!
Okay, okay, awesome! Can you give me a suggestion of something that your mother has given you? Anything.
Any,
something that your mother has given you.
The name Sam.
My name? We'll go self-esteem. And then, can I have a location for Al?
Paradise.
Hogwarts!
Sam? Alright, okay. I know it is your first day of the third grade.
Yeah.
And I just need to tell you.
Yeah, it is.
You are good enough.
You
can do it. You can do all the math problems, and I don't want you to let Logan tell you any different, because he's a little turd. Don't let him boss you around. You're enough. You're magnificent. Yeah. Yes.
And I also packed, I got your lunchbox off the floor.
I packed you your favorite fruity snacks to remind you that you're my little gem, like the fruit color. You're my little gem.
No juice box, and so how
Sam.
Am I supposed to know how to do anything?
Alex, look at this is so amazing! I can't believe I'm here! It's Hogwarts!
Oh.
Woo! We're going to Wizard! Woo! Do you think we'll get sorted into the right house?
Do you think we're going to die?
Why would we die? This is Hogwarts! We have magic! I don't understand.
We have 10 minutes until a hat decides our fate.
Yeah!
We're gonna die?
Yes!
I don't have good hand-eye coordination. I'm gonna kill someone.
Yeah! Woo! Yeah!
I found the note in your backpack from Logan. I don't even want to speak it into existence, but I just want you to know.
Wait, you mean my friend Logan? We're best friends now. What did he write for me?
Nothing!
I need it. We're gonna put this one here.
No.
And then this one goes there, and it goes. I don't know what that word is. Hold on.
It says
you are.
Good enough!
But I don't know what it is. I need to see it for myself, for my self-esteem. I need to know that he loves me. Because that's my best friend. I need friends.
Alright, well, at least have a juice box to you.
Juice box!
Alex! Some weird things have been happening. I was walking in the halls the other day, and there was a dead person.
the only two people left, actually.
So they found...
I mean...
What? He died? Oh my god, that's so surprising.
Are you trying to tell me that when you said at the beginning of the year that people were going to die, that you killed them all?
What?
Did you fucking murder these people, Alex?
What?
I don't know what's wrong with me!
Okay, I thought of a good plan because I'm your best friend and your mom. I'm thinking homeschool!
Okay, awesome! So next up, some of our folks are gonna go on a date! Woo-hoo! Yeah. Alright, Samuel, get out of here. Leave! Samuel! So he's gonna need some excuses as to why he's late, and the wait staff here at the restaurant are gonna help him figure out what those excuses are. So first, I need a real reason that you'd be late for something.
Had bad breath, Mr. Toast.
About the toothpaste. Ran out of toothpaste. All right. Second, a more obscure reason, but okay, it could happen.
Burned his toast. His dog shat on everything.
I'm brushing my teeth, okay? Because I gotta have them into freshness. And my toothpaste exploded all over the place. It got all over me.
Well, I don't see it anywhere, so clearly a lot.
I was rummaging through my medicine cabinet, and everything was missing. I couldn't read the labels. I couldn't find my toothpaste. And so I couldn't brush my teeth.
It's right here from the counter. It's not that hard. You can keep it literally right
here. Yeah, but I didn't have my glasses on me. And so I couldn't see. The lights are out. It's dark. And
excuse me.
Yes.
Can I please get that iced tea that I ordered?
Yeah, sure. One second.
This glass is so dirty.
What they're doing. Here you go. Thank you.
We had a hard time. We lost the glasses.
This is
a shitty restaurant.
I'm
sorry, that was the wrong thing. We were all out of vodka.
So yeah, I lost my toothpaste, and it was empty. They were all out. And I bought a spare, and I lost the spare, and so that's...
What about your spare toothpaste? That's a necessity.
My mom, I don't know.
Okay, well anyways, that doesn't explain why you're 2.5 hours late. That would be
okay, look, I gotta tell you a secret. I'm a runway model on the side, and people were taking my photos because I'm also a celebrity. And just, yeah, so I was meeting my fans, and... Yeah, and... Oh my god, wait a minute, I'm sorry. I lied. I know, I'm sorry. I think I met a very popular model or celebrity. I think it was like Arnold Schwarzenegger or something. I tried to do my impression. Like, I'll be back. Yeah, so that's important.
I don't feel like that's the whole truth.
You're right. I had to eat a giant sub before I came.
We're cleaning up a mess.
We're trying to have a private discussion here, please.
Throw it on the ground, it's fine. Nice athlete.
I know, right? Look. I was reaching into something. The oven? I was reaching into something. And I was pulling something out. Look, I had a lot of things going on today and I forgot like half of them.
Here's your appetizer. Sorry, it's a little overdone.
I'm at this restaurant!
I'm so sorry.
Well, if you're reaching into your oven, I hope you had your mitt on.
Yes.
Terribly sorry, we forgot to bring you out your complimentary side of bread.
Yeah, so I was baking, and
you're not very good at baking,
right? Where are my Google shapes, apparently? Okay, look. I burned two jumping jacks. I burnt the bread that I was making. Two loaves of bread. Two pieces of bread. Yeah!
It was terrible.
There was jam everywhere, and none of it was on the sandwich. And my husband came home and yelled at me because of my decision to give my son the jam and the butter knife, and it was just jam.
Have you ever seen a steak knife before, sir? Do you know the difference between a steak knife and a goddamn plate knife?
Hi, my name is Michael. I'm here with Child Protective Services.
Yes, I... You guys keep coming over, I don't see what the problem is. My son was just playing with the knife and the jam. I mean, I was trying to get him to use the jam, but...
Playing with the knife?
Well, to smear on the bread. So, like, you know when you want to eat a sandwich. So I was trying to teach him to do that himself, so I don't have to do it.
He just turned 21, he's not ready for that. We've been over this.
He did really well in school, so I thought that maybe, just maybe, he'd be able to pull off the butter knife.
Goodness. This is why Child Protective Services keeps visiting. We can't trust you with your child, and so we will take your child.
All right.
Hey, Mom, these, like, CPS people keep coming over and, like, ask me if I want to go with them, and I'm, like, thinking of mine. They seem pretty chill.
My darling boy.
Yeah, Mom.
So, I have to stop letting you use the butter knife.
I'm so good at it.
I know, you're making great progress, son. But they keep coming. Child Protective Services wants to take you away. They said if I stop giving you the butter knife, they won't take you. But if I don't, if I push you to your limits, they'll take you away.
That's not right, Mom.
That's not right. I'm here to encourage you.
The world's not fair.
I'm here to encourage you.
Who's gonna do my laundry if I go with them? You won't be.
Look, Dolores. I want a divorce. It is obvious that you cannot take care of our son. The Child Protective Services are looking to take him away from us. And I've been talking to them.
We don't need this. We don't need this.
I don't need you.
I've been trying for you.
Trying?
And our son, who is out bowling.
Bowling? Again, Dolores, please.
I thought he held the ball.
And we're back. So, how did you feel when your son was bowling and he happened to walk behind the bowling alley and saw you laying in the alley with your box, sleeping out of it?
Well, it all started when my husband...
Do you feel like you deserve it?
No, I just wanted my son to have the self-confidence to push himself forward.
So you gave him a knife and thought he'd push that forward. Oh. What do you want him to push that knife forward into, sir?
The jam!
Hi.
Thanks
for
calling. What do you need again?
I've been doing really well. I haven't given my son any knives. I stopped letting him go bowling. I stopped encouraging the bowling.
Hey, your son doesn't live with you anymore. What are you talking about? You lost him in the divorce, remember? We had to help move this stuff.
So, this isn't my son.
That is a sack of potatoes. And it looks like it needs changed. Alright, sir, for the last time, I'm going to have to ask you to take these pills.
Why? Why on earth do I need to?
You were put in this hospital because you're really sick. You need to take these pills. I'm not interviewing you for anything. I've just been asking you, please take these pills.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Should it work?
Mom, it's been so many years.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, son.
Oh, my God. You recovered.
I just want you to know that I can make a perfect jam sandwich!
Hey, our last game tonight is three scene tag. So we're gonna have three pairs of improvisers doing three different scenes, and they're gonna be stealing lines from each other. So for Lena and Samuel, can I get a suggestion of something that you might find in your garage?
A human ear!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
A human ear? All right, for Emmett and Casey, first line of dialogue, maybe something you might hear at a drag.
Look, it's my Bible! It's my Bible!
Hey,
you want to
get
this?
Look, it's my Bible.
Dragon fruit is my favorite animal. And for Parker and Michael, let's get a location.
Chuck E. Cheese!
I knew you'd like him. I picked him up. Look, you know, little red eyes.
love teeth, but the ear thing is kind of weird.
Look, Mom, it's just a phase, God.
That's what you said about the teeth.
Yeah, and now it's an ear thing. Get up with the times.
Oh, God, I swear. Children, right? Okay.
It's not even like, I just found it, okay? It's not even like a big deal. Not even a big deal.
What?
I just found it. Just found it.
That's not, wait.
I just found it. That's it, okay? Don't ask any questions, Mom! Jeez!
Before that, you implied that you didn't just find it, that you... How did you acquire the ear, Steve?
My friend Becky gave it to me.
My friend Becky gave it to me, you know.
Yeah,
she's the one who hooked us up with the tickets and the free jacuzzi. The free everything over here.
How do you meet Becky?
Oh, she goes to my youth group.
Oh. Youth group?
Yeah, I run the thing, so.
Oh, yeah.
And how old is Becky?
She's the age of consent, all right?
She's a consenting adult.
In what country?
In our country. God damn it.
I'm concerned.
Do you like the jacuzzi? Let's just talk about
that. Let's put the jacuzzi behind us. I know your track record.
I know your track record, Steve. It started with the teeth, and then the ear. Now toes? Are you kidding me? That's disgusting.
Can I just play Dungeons and Dragons with my friends in peace, Mom?
Yeah.
Look, it's just a prop. Just because it's a real toe doesn't mean it's scary. Jeez.
Do you hear yourself? Do you hear yourself? It grew to be 3 feet long.
Wow.
It fit in my hand and you said it was full grown.
I shouldn't have gotten
another one. It's a fucking mammoth rat.
Yeah, I should have gotten another one.
Okay.
Meet Becky.
Oh, how old is she?
She's 12.
No!
She's 12. My daughter is 12 years old.
And she likes going to church with me.
Yeah, that's where she met Becky.
Oh, nothing weird about that.
I'd like to hope so.
Yeah.
God damn it. I'm not really threatening me right here, you know? I'm not the one standing outside of the jacuzzi. I feel like you keep drifting away from me, so I don't know.
I feel like you keep drifting away from me. I don't know where you are.
Because you're not cool, Mom!
Oh my God!
Oh, you don't even do drugs like all the other moms!
You need to do drugs like all the other moms and not bring home rats! These mammoth rats! This one is the size of a dinner table! And this one is the size of a... Well, it's just a small rug right now. It's kind of cute. But please, dear God, tell me you did not bring any more rats. Just...
No, no more rats, but I did get another surprise.
Samples! Hi! Go ahead! Strap him up! Dips on... We're gonna start a new life. I can't do the teeth, I can't do the toes, and I definitely can't do the ears.
Alright, we're gonna go to LA. We're gonna start a new life. Forget about the toes, forget about the ears. We're just
what about the ears?